Hello, and welcome to this film, which is all about acid dissociation constants, or things that we call Ka for short. We've got some slightly unwelcome visitors here at the moment, but we're going to carry on and make the film anyway. And hopefully by the end of it, you'll be able to understand what an acid dissociation constant actually is, and you'll be able to look at the size of Ka, the acid dissociation constant, and decide how strong or weak an acid must be. Okay, so before we really get going, let's have a quick reminder of what equilibrium constants look like, because this was covered in another topic. Okay, so you might remember this thing called Kc. Now, Kc was an equilibrium constant K measured in terms of concentration. So in our expression, we had the concentrations of our products on top, our reactants on the bottom, and the equation that might have given us this equilibrium constant would have looked like the reactants, A and B, reacting together to form the products, C and D. But what is more, we've got some powers in this expression, and they came from the stoichiometric coefficients in our chemical equation. And hopefully another thing that you might remember is that if something in this equation had been a liquid, so let's say that B here was water, right? Because the concentration of a pure liquid or a pure solid can't change, then the concentration of that thing is not a variable in this expression, and so we don't include it in our expression. So let's just say that B had been water, we wouldn't see it in our equilibrium constant expression. Okay, so there's a quick reminder of equilibrium constants. Now let's have a look at what these things look like in the context of acids. So one of the first things you might notice is that now that we're talking about an acid equilibrium constant or an acid dissociation constant, we call it Ka, and that's just because it's an equilibrium constant that's talking about an acid. So now let's think about what happens when an acid dissociates. So hopefully you're quite good now at writing hydrolysis equations for acids, and here's an acid, ethanoic acid, reacting with water. And as we know, the H plus ion of the acid is given to this water molecule, which is acting as a base, and we're going to form the conjugate base of ethanoic acid, the CH3CO minus ion, and also the conjugate acid of water, the H3O plus ion, or the hydroxonium ion. Now, if we were to talk in general terms about what the dissociation of an acid would look like, then we could say, well, there's an H plus ion in our acid, and that's joined to an anion, a negative ion, which we'll call A in general. Okay? And if HA reacts with water, then HA will give its proton, its H plus ion, to the water molecule, and it will form the conjugate base of HA, which is A minus. So that's our general representation of the anion in an acid, and H3O plus. But notice here, like we were saying before, we've got water in our equation. Okay, so that means we will not see water in our equilibrium constant expression, and our equilibrium constant expression will have the products A minus, the anion from our acid, multiplied by the concentration of H3O plus, divided by the concentration of the undissociated acid on the bottom. Okay, so this is why it's called an acid dissociation constant. Okay, and you might see here that we've got the symbols EQ in this equation. This is, I suppose, unnecessary because it's already obvious that these things are at equilibrium because it's an equilibrium constant expression. So these are not necessary to include. Okay, but the EQ just means that these are concentrations at equilibrium. Okay, so that's what an acid dissociation constant looks like. And hopefully you remember from the equilibrium constant that from the work that you did on the equilibrium constants before, is that the bigger K is, the more products form in that equilibrium. And that is absolutely true for acids as well. So the larger Ka is, the more over to the right our equilibrium will lie. So this hydrolysis of the acid or its dissociation will lie far over to the right-hand side if Ka is large. Okay? In other words, our acid will be strong if Ka is very large because most of HA will split up into these ions. If the acid is weak and not very much of it does, then Ka will be small because there'll be lots of undissociated acid and not very many ions. So let's just have a look at this table here. Now, I'm going to start with by looking for, I suppose, the best known acid, which is hydrochloric acid. Now you'll see here that hydrochloric acid doesn't appear. Now why is that? Well, remember what we said about strong acids was that they ionize completely, or they dissociate completely in aqueous solution, which means that the concentration of HA will be zero. And if you put zero into this expression, then obviously Ka becomes infinity. So anything that is strong doesn't appear in this table because it doesn't really have a Ka value. Okay? The exception here is sulfuric acid. They've included its first Ka, so that's its first ionization when it loses its first proton, but they've said it's strong, so it doesn't really have a value. But this number here indicates that there is a Ka for the second ionization of H2SO4 when it loses its second H plus ion, because that dissociation is weak. And that's something that we've covered before as well. Let's have a look at arsenous acid here. It's got a Ka of 5.1 times 10 to the minus 10. So that's a tiny value. That means that hardly any of it dissociates. Ethanoic acid, or in other words, acetic acid, 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. Okay? So the bigger Ka is, the stronger the acid is, the smaller it is, the weaker it is. But remember that strong acids don't really have Ka values because they basically ionize completely. Okay, so that's it. That's everything covered. Well, it's introduced what an acid dissociation constant is and what the size of it tells us about the strength of an acid. If you've got any questions, then by all means, feel free to come and find me or to post a comment on YouTube. And hopefully by the time we make the next film, we'll have got rid of all these unwelcome guests.